the Xtreme Walleye Angler is presented by Go Fish in Ontario. It's catching.
Early September, when you get those cold snaps and the water temperatures go down to about 63, 62. For me, there's a couple things I do. Chase smallmouth, chase walleye, crappie and stuff. But man, I get out the good old hair jig, or bucktail jig, people call it. It's that snap jigging that I'm addicted to. Going out, reading weed lines, putting it out in front of the boat and just snap. And you say, well, if you catch bass and stuff like that, you're using the walleye rod. It doesn't matter, are you kidding? St. Croix Legend Tournament Walleye, and I'm gonna fish this little, I got a quarter ounce, because I'm fishing anywhere between 10 and 12 feet of water. It's that last 2 feet of the water column that I'm interested in. Those fish are roaming around. So a little bit heavier weight, like a banana style, black, the chartreuse silhouette. This is more about the reaction, snap, snap. I can cover a lot of water, use the right rod. So Legend Tournament Walleye might catch me a whole abundance of critters on the hair jig. Let's find out. There we go. I think that's Mr. Walleye. Is it Mr. Walleye? It's fighting more like pike, maybe. Is it pike or big walleye? You never know. What are you? Northern or walleye? Nope, Mr. Largemouth. Look at that. Mr. Largemouth on the bucktail. A fat little largemouth too. Coming out for walleyes and getting Mr. Largemouth. Fat little guy, first thing in the morning. Ooh, let's let him go. We're not looking for you, are we? No, but hey man. Hair jigs in September can be one of the most deadliest ways to catch fish. I'm gonna show you how we do it with the tackle, the locations, and hopefully some more and bigger ones just like that. Let's just keep going. Man, when I find the edge of the weeds, it's just like gold. Really, it's just like gold. I use that Garmin, I sit on the edge of the weeds, and I see the sparse stuff first, about 2 feet above the bottom, with nothing, like sand, then some more sparse. And I can see when the sun comes out each time, the real darkness, the weed comes up 5, 6, 7 feet over about 10 to 12. That's the ticket. That's the ticket. Where those fish are sitting with their nose out, whether it be the largemouth, the pike, or the walleye, they're right on that edge. It's so, so important. Following what your sonar shows you, use the sun, see the dark shadows, put that bucktail up there, and just snap it. But remember, it has to go all the way down, right to the bottom. That's the beauty of the bucktail or the hair jig. You can cover the whole water column. Just eat it up. Eat that hair. Oh, look at that, see? Look at that. That's a gorgeous, gorgeous fish right there. Look at it. Look at that. Sitting on the edge out here. Look at how big, how beautiful. Hey? Big, beautiful walleyes. They get hooked on the hair. Oh, God. That's what I'm looking for right there. That's what I came for. That's what I wanted to catch. And throwing the hair, you can't miss. Let me show you exactly where he's got it here. Hold on, walleye, hold on. I ain't gonna hurt you. I got you on the outside there. Look where he's got that hair jig. Look at that. Tell me he wanted that hair, huh? Oh yeah. Find that hook, right there you are, right there. Hold on. Just a nice, beautiful walleye, eh? From OM Resort right here in Opeongo, man. You talk about Ontario walleyes, it's amazing. Okay, oh, you think he was okay? A couple quick snaps, let him go so you can come here, you can catch him at that resort right there. Opeongo Mountain Resort for walleye, largemouth, smallmouth, you name it, because it is here, boy. Got the hair jig on, catch some more fish. Stick around, we'll be right back. It's so important to have quality stuff. The St. Croix, I just feel those subtle bites. Some of the walleye's just been like, dick. Some of them obviously you saw just whack right away. But having the quality equipment, You can use like the Icon rod by St.Croix. I got the Legend Tournament ones, only because specifically I'm using it for the snap jig, which is a snap jig rod. So I can just put it out, snap, snap. And it's about repetition, being more stubborn than them, finding where they are, and just keep throwing it, throwing it, throwing it. And the law of averages is you're going to find them whether you use little grubs or the hair jig with the snap jig rod. If you're persistent and just get it in your head, it's not every pitch catching a fish. Just go, 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 and then, boom, you got them. Right down the edge of the weed. Hopefully the fish have their face right into the weed or into the wind. Most times they do. I think I can just fish this edge. Just enough wind, just enough. What else is hiding on these weeds? Because all of a sudden, there it goes right there. Look, another walleye too, eh? Wow. Look, just an eating size one. You could say eating size. That's what people come for right there. That's a nice eating size walleye right there. All depending on where you fish. Just a nice fish. Look at that. He took it up high. Look where my marker buoy is right there. Look at that. See that right there? Tell me that doesn't help when you have a marker buoy. Oh, okay. Right, little walleye. Let you go right here. Kiss and release, okay? Kiss and release. I'll put him right here. Ready? Go on. Now my pitches, that's the crucial part. Right there. I would say about 50 feet, 40 feet. I'm not making long bomb casts. I'm covering those weed edges and contours, the little dips and drops and inside bends, outside bends of the weed. And you can only do that by making those specific casts or underhand pitches to the weed you see. Oh yeah. Got here, man. They got northerns here too. Looks like it. Whoa, easy boy. It is a northern too. Look at walleyes, northerns, largemouth, you name it. It's all here. It all wants to eat the hair jig, doesn't it? Oh yeah. It all wants to eat the hair jig. Come here, boy. Look where he's got it too. So lucky. Little northerns too. Not too bad, eh? Go on. You what? Come out. And the second part of the show is going to show when I came a little earlier in September with my buddy Seabass. We got some largemouth and we got some really good walleyes with the big magnum rage bug fishing on the edges and stuff, you know, fishing for big largemouth, and it was awesome. So I want to come back on this part of the show and show you that different time of the year. It's almost, I think it's September 30th, the little hair jig going along the weed lines, throwing it in and snapping it and getting a reaction bite. And we're catching all kinds of fish. We're catching largemouth, we're catching pike, and we're catching some real nice walleye. So stick around, because we'll be right back with the early September catching them on the big rage bug. Big game fish, when they gang up together, pushing bait against weed and stuff, could be smallmouth, northerns, largemouth, but in this case, big, beautiful walleyes. You can't beat it, man. In Ontario, we got so many different lakes and fisheries and stuff like that, but those beautiful walleyes that inhabit the same deep weed as those largemouth we're catching, you can't beat it. And the magnum rage bug, it's exactly big profile, like a big perch or something like that that comes into their view. They see it, man. They are a predator. They eat it. Look at the size of this walleye. Look at the size of this walleye, dude.
Okay, I'm gonna get the net, buddy.
Yeah, look at the size of this walleye. I just missed one.
Hey. There we go.
Hey. Magnum bug. Magnum bug bugs everything, including beautiful big walleyes. Just popped out. Look at that, eh?
Oh, beauty, we'll put him in for
pigs. Eating fish, huh?
Yeah, and that's the slot here.
Yeah.
It's gotta be over 20, it's
okay, beautiful. Let's see that for a second.
Yep.
Just to make 100% sure. I'm sure it is, but. I know they're gonna pop around as soon as they, hold on you.
He might be a 22.
22. Unreal, eh? You say to yourself, rage tail plastics? Big rage bugs for walleyes? It goes to show you, man, when those walleyes are schooled together on a deep weed edge, like they are very, very competitive. And that big bait with those kicking feet and stuff like that, it's just, it's too enticing. The walleyes see it, the walleyes push the largemouth out of the way and decide, I'm gonna eat that bug.
There we go.
Look at the size of this walleye.
Oh my, oh, is that a big?
No, it's a big walleye, dude.
Okay, I got the net. That is a tank. Oh, right there, hey. Buddy.
Wow, hey, hold on for a sec.
That's a picture fish.
Wow, look at that rage bug, huh? You think they're just for bass? I say not. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Beautiful Ontario walleyes. What are you waiting for? Come to Ontario, it's catching. Walleyes on the Magnum Rage Bug. Anything is possible with a soft Strike King, perfect plastics, the Rage baits, you name it. Because the texture, smell, everything about it, man, but that patented Rage Tail kick drives those walleyes nuts. And a 3/8 ounce falling in that 12 to 13 feet of water going down, it's just there. It's in their face. It's going down. And I can't tell you how many times they just, whoa, they slash at it, and you feel your line jump, and you think you got a fish. But boy, when those big ones want it, they got it.
Okay, I'm switching to chartreuse.
Oh, look at this walleye.
Another tank?
Oh, just a good one. Look at him in the water. Look at that. Here's what you got to do. Throw that out.
Carl,
look at him.
Got him right here.
What do you think this one was? In the weeds? Look at you. Whoa, hold on.
That's a thick fish.
Yeah.
Look at the gold on him.
Yeah, right in the weed. Look at that. Look at the mouth inside there too. That big 5-odd. Man, you can't beat it, eh? Come out for bass on deep weed in September in the Ottawa Valley in Ontario. You can't beat it, man. Deep weed, you find that weed, everything wants to eat, including the walleyes, the smallmouth, the largemouth, the pike, you name it. So we're gonna call through. In this lake, you're allowed 19.7 and higher. You're allowed 2 each. So we're gonna let one of the smaller ones go. And we're gonna keep this one. Enjoy a nice, fantastic dinner right here in Ontario. If you haven't done it before, you gotta get here, man. Ontario boy, it's catching. Beautiful, golden walleyes waiting for you. Want to fall exactly where you're pitching it. I mean, sometimes precise on those weed lines and stuff, it's very imperative that when those fish decide to feed and they're on the edges in areas where maybe drop off to main lake breaks and things like that, that's imperative that this little bait gets within, I'd say, you know, a 2-foot, 3-foot area that you're looking at, you see on the sonar, where you want this bait to fall, because that's where those big game fish are hunkered down and looking to eat.
Buddy. Nice one, buddy.
What do we got here?
Big
oh,
eye.
You know what's here. Look at this thing. Look. Look. Ontario walleyes, dude. Look at. Oh, wow, eh?
Look at that, Carl. There you go, hey? Buddy.
Wow. Look how golden yellow. And you say to yourself sometimes, you know, where you get them and stuff. Just look how yellow they are. Look at that. Just a gorgeous, beautiful example of Ontario walleye right there. Look at that rage bug. You think you wanted that, man? You think when you're on the spot, you mark the spot? Boy, you just gotta use the electronics, waypoints, marker buoys. He's kind of small, eh? No?
Yeah. He's under a limit here, Carl. There you go, buddy.
Let's see? Has to be 20?
Has to be 20.
He's a little over, but here. Ontario, catch and release. For tomorrow.
Hi, my name is Kat.
I'm Niels, and we are the owner of Opeongo Mountain Resort.
We have six beautiful cottages, either two or three bedrooms. They can sleep up to six people.
We also have 100 campsites, 92 seasonal sites, and we have 8 short-term sites.
We have a little restaurant on site that is open during the summer, on the weekends, in the off-season when the kids are back in school. A little ice cream parlor is part of it too, with some sweets and anything that you could have missed to bring.
We also have a full-equipped marina with rental boats from 14-foot aluminum boats, 9.9 horsepower up to 25 horsepower, 16-foot boats, fully fish setup, and also 3-pontoon boats with fishing setup like life well, fish finder, and a gas station too.
And even if fishing is not for you, we are a family-owned business. We love our children, and we have a big beach for kids to play with the water slide. We have kids' events every weekend. We have loads of little playground areas that you can take your children to.
You can also rent kayaks, canoes, paddle boats. We even have a stand-up paddle boat.
Our events range from kids to grown-up events. We have annual fishing tournaments. We have our sea car races, pig roasts, Thanksgiving dinners, big Canada Day celebration with bands and fireworks. There's always something for everybody to do.
We want you here soon at Opeongo Mountain Resort.
Walleyes on the hair jig, it goes to show you, doesn't it, that people say, you know, the water temperature's cooled down, you gotta slow down. That's the exact opposite when you're using the hair jig and snapping it and stuff. I'm getting a reaction bite. Think about it, the water's pretty cold, and these largemouth, they are just smacking that hair jig, smacking it. And you see how far down they got it? They wanna eat it. They're not playing, coming up and looking at it and turning sideways, looking at it. They see it, they are swimming, they are moving their tail and eating that hair jig. Wow, look at those things fight, dude. Look at those things fight. Tell me that's not fun, man.
Whoa.
What are you, huh? Another nice largemouth. Look at that one. Oh, boy. That's a good one. Maybe I'll just swing this one in, too. Let's see. Oh, yeah. That one decided he's going to eat it. Look at that. That's a chunk right there. Oh yeah, I just saw some things when the wake's going by from the boat. I saw, that's what he thought it was, perch right there. I saw some feeding activity, and sometimes in September, look at, they're not big fish, but look at the girth on these fish, man. Look at them, tell me they're not eating. Beautiful, healthy largemouth. What an exciting, exciting way to fish. You go around and around and around, and like I said before, catch a fish, that's the deal. Throw the marker, boy. Now I got two out here. And the reference points. Yes, the Garmin tell me exactly where I want to fish. I'm looking for those edges from 10 to 12 feet of water with weed. But the better fish have come from sparse stuff. And with the sunglasses, I see like light shadows of maybe gravel or sand. Maybe that's where they're feeding. But I mean, when you snap that little hair jig with the walleye snap jig rod and it goes, it's like electricity goes through your body. Oh, get back at it and maybe catch some more. September is the time of plenty. They know that winter's coming and they know it's time to stack up, put on the feed bag. So when you find them, you know you're gonna catch them. You know, try the snap jig, try the hair jigs, and try getting out there and try something new. And that's what it's all about, you know? Get out of your comfort zone. The snap jig technique is something that you get your own system of how far to cast, your cadence, how long you should leave the jig on the bottom. You'll figure out yourself and what's comfortable for you, but get out the snap jig, pull out the hair jigs, and definitely go out fishing.
Right there. Yep.
Just finished saying, huh? Another Walter, I think. Walter? Walter? Yes, sir. Look at, right on the edge of that weed. Look at that. Another nice walleye sitting where he should have sat. Here's what I'll do right quick, right now. Okay, right there. Put it down. I'll bump into it, but that's okay. Another nice walleye. Look at that. Right on the weed edge. I said about the rain coming. I said potentially you're gonna catch fish, and we are. Here's another thing that I'm gonna do, okay? Real quick, it's on sleep. I'm gonna mark it, and boom, symbol. And where's the fish? Right there, boom. Then back. Now I got the spot mark exactly where we're. Let's let him go, okay? Ready, walleye? Beautiful Opeongo Mountain Resort walleye. Marker boy going right by. So being prepared. Marker buoys, proper sonar. Here's the best thing about this. You don't want to kill your batteries, okay? So you put it like that. It's a sleep station. So this is asleep, that's asleep. This one's awake, I'm awake. You're gonna be awake if you come up here to Opeongo Mountain Resort and catch some walleyes, some smallmouth, some largemouth, northerns, you name it. But break it up sometimes. Put down the plastic, put down the little grubs, and get a reaction strike from walleye with the bucktail. Thanks for watching. We're gonna see you next time, right here in Ontario. Go Fish Ontario, you know why? It's catching.
Experience the excellent fishing and lodge hospitality for yourself by calling Opeongo Mountain Resort at 1-800-565-9623 or visit them online at www.omresort.ca. The Xtreme Walleye Angler has been presented by Go Fish in Ontario. It's catching. St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Catch us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.